Welcome back to yet another episode on the Shiddy channel. Yet again, back in the Shiddy shop. Today we're going to be working on the USS Enterprise and finishing up our brake job. So last week, we did the front brakes, we changed the oil, we changed spark plugs. We did the typical routine maintenance. We got the front side done. So now we're gonna do these rear brakes today. These rear brakes are just as simple as the front, but we get to use our new fancy tool. Now I would like to take this opportunity to thank all 91 of you who are currently subscribed to the Shiddy channel. This started off as just an idea, and we weren't sure what was going to happen. We ain't the biggest out there or nothing yet, but there's some numbers. We're doing okay. Way better than what I thought we would do. With the big number 91 being mentioned, that means we're close to 100, right? 9 more of you. You need to hit that subscribe button. Get us up to 100 subscribers, and maybe we'll do something cool, all right? Live stream or some music stuff. There just hasn't been a big demand for the music stuff. And, the garage stuff seems to be doing the best so far. So help us get to 100 subscribers, guys. Come on. All you gotta do is like, share, subscribe. You know the jingle. It doesn't cost you anything. It's free. Plus you get some corny entertainment. All right, we don't know, okay? We're here, it's all that matters, all right? We're here to bring the entertainment to you. So, thank you, all right? Thank you a lot. So without further ado, let's get into it, all right? Let's do brakes, rear brakes. So, some of you may remember from last week about me telling you about the rear disc and rotor stuff. All right, the rear. The front's simple. You can take C-clamp and the old brake pad, twist it on there, and shove that cylinder back in. Now, on rears, you can't do that. They twist in, right? They twist in and out. That's how they work. They go in, they go out. If you just try to force that in there with a clamp or something, you're going to burn up your caliper. All right, you're going to mess some stuff up. But again, for like $15, you can go to your local parts store and pick up one of these universal cubes. All right. You put your socket in the center. Make sure you get an extension to clear everything, and you use this to turn that cylinder in. I've never used one of these. I've always just fought them. All right. Made them turn. Screwdriver stuff, slowly, it would take forever. So we're gonna see how much this little guy will help us do these rear brakes. Not for impact use. Remember that, hand tools, easy. And today's video is sponsored by Shiddy Half Songs, which is us. Still, like we said before, we've still got a handful of these beautiful, handmade, Shiddy Half Songs t-shirts. All right. Made them ourselves, in-house. Printed them ourselves, in-house. Each shirt is custom. Custom design. One of a kind. You won't find another one like it, all right? Now, these are Shiddy Half Songs shirts, which, is our band that we had, that we still tinker with every now and then. But coming up soon, we are gonna have Shiddy Channel shirts to where it still says the classic Shiddy at the top, but then it's gonna say Channel here, Because we are Shiddy Enterprises or whatever, and we have so many different branches of Shiddy that you don't know what's good and what's not. Let's get back to the video.
So we're going to start by setting our parking brake. Right there. You can use your foot if you're sitting in the car. Or you can just push her down with your hand. Or just, you know. Oops. Don't want to go too far. You just release it.
You'll then want to jack up your car.
There's a pinch weld with a little cutout. And that's where your jack goes.
All right, we're going to take the tire off now. And we're going to be using a 19 millimeter. If you don't have an impact or anything like that, before you jack up your car, you'll want to break all your nuts loose. Or else, you know. Well, if you set the parking brake on the rear, that'll help you. But if you don't, it'll just spin. All right, and it'll be not fun. This makes it easier, though. But little effort with that. Sometimes if you just hit on it a little bit, it'll come off there.
Look at your good looking tar with your bow tie and your little stuffs.
Now, first objective, we're going to take off the caliper. Starting with the slide fins, two 14 millimeter bolts, one on the bottom, one on the top. Pull this out of the way. Oh, she don't want to slide off there. Duh. Don't forget to undo your parking brake. Yeah. Now you see, once you undo your parking brake that you forgot to, it'll slide off like it doesn't even care. Step 2, 47, 69, whatever, 32, 18 millimeter. You gotta get the bracket off now. So it looks like we got a 118 up here. You see where the other one's at? Right there. So once you get your caliper and everything off, if you can, try to leave your pads and everything in the bracket when you take it off. That way, if you're inexperienced at this, you can do it side at a time and everything. And that way you don't forget how it goes, okay? So we got that off, and now let's see if we can get this, I believe it's a Torx 30 or something like that, out of this one. We had to drill out the front too. Are we gonna have to drill these out too? A lot of stuff's been seized. Let's try.
I got a feeling we're gonna have to drill this out. Found a proper T30 bit. I just realized the reason why I think the other ones were breaking on me because they were 27s. Close, but not quite. You know, I wouldn't believe it if I didn't see it. It came off.
All right. So we've got our new hardware, our new pads. We've got our new rotor. We're going to take off the old rotor. Mm-hmm.
So the biggest reason why I say wait to pull all this apart until you're ready is because there are a difference in your pads. You got this little tang. Don't ask me what it's called, I have no idea. But you'll want to put your new pads on exactly how your old pads are, okay? Easiest way to explain it. You should have four new pieces of hardware. They go here and here. And then a pad goes on each side. And obviously the two you don't use over here, you'll use on the other side. Same thing, just take your time, pay attention. And then it's a repeat process. So on this caliper, sits on the car like so. It's really, it doesn't matter. It's just put it together how it came apart. So we'll pop this pad out. See how it came out like this? We'll just lay it like this. Find our matching pad. And we'll just sit it right there. Now these pieces of hardware are all the same. So it's two for each side. Slide this other guy out. Come. Bam. Now the other pad, they're the same. So you don't have to watch out for your little tank. So we'll just put the other pads back in the box for the other side. Or just grab them from the back. And they'll come off. Then we'll just pull it off. That's the part where if you pay attention, it helps, you know. Sometimes my brain just don't work, guys. Alright, sometimes it just doesn't work. You just pop them in there, all right? You'll hear them. You'll know when they're in. Just gotta tell it that it's going home, all right? Force it in there.
You gotta love working on cars. The reason why the new hardware wasn't fitting up right is, yeah, you guessed it. It's because they're not the right ones. I went to put the pad in, I was like, oh, this ain't working right. That hardware is not seated correctly. So I was like, oh, I'll put the old hardware back in. Oh, this pad's not working. It's too tall. Call a parts store. Come to find out, there are two different rear pads for these cars. Front's all the same. Why is the back gotta be different? Why you gotta have a big one and a little one, you know? So this goes out to all you car manufacturers out there who won't see this. Think about the little guys, all right? Instead of making all kinds of different options for one vehicle, pick one, okay? Pick one. Go with it, you know? So, needless to say, I'm going to have to hitch me a ride somewhere. Just got a battle in the town. Swap out these pads so we can get back at it. But this is part of working on cars, okay? I mean, unless you are master mechanic or been doing it forever, you might know these things going into it. But we're just your average, everyday shitty mechanic, right? So, we'll be back soon.
Taxi! Oh wait, we're in the middle of nowhere. There are no taxis.
All right guys, we are back from the parts store run.
I think we got the right pad, so let's give it another try, shall we?
Alrighty. So let's see if this new hardware goes in any easier. Yep. Mm-hmm. Like it was made for it as well. I won with the Tang. Goes here. Whoa. So she don't squeak and squeak and squeak. Alright.
So we're gonna go ahead and put our caliper bracket and new pads on.
Now the moment that 27.8% of you have been waiting for is the rear caliper piston. Now how do we get that to go in? See how it's got kind of a pattern to it? There's four places where you need to put a tool. Now our new tool just so happens to have a side that has four tabs. These four tabs will hook into there perfectly. So you can get on there and turn it in.
Turn it.
Sends that piston right on in. Nice and easy. Once you get her down and in there, slides right into place, nice and easy. Now we're getting close to our final steps, guys. We just need to put our 214s back into the pins. Into the sliders. You know, trying to work things backwards in the camera is kind of challenging. You can make a game out of it. Did I do it?
I think I did.
All right, so we'll just snug up these two 14s and put our wheel back on. That's it. All right. Once you press the brake, that'll push your piston back out and get everything situated. So we're gonna tighten these up and pop the wheel back on, repeat the process on the other side. Since you already watched me fiddle fart around on this side, we're just gonna do the other side off camera and call this done. All right guys, we got it all done. And I do say it's got a lot of brake pedal now. It's fantastic. So that's going to wrap up this video. I'd like to thank everybody for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. We'll catch you on the next one.